Welcome into this video, guys. Today I'm doing some deer scouting. It is mid-June. It's a little later than I would hope to be out here scouting, but this is when I can get out. So I'm on a new piece of public ground today. Grant and I actually hunted on this property on the other side last year. Grant killed a doe, and we saw quite a few different deer in there. We didn't see any buck, but we didn't scout it at all. And we just got in there and were able to harvest a doe. I'm on the other side of the property today, and I am working my way in deep. There's a lot of guys that hunt this side closer to the road, but I'm going in probably 3/4 mile to 1.5 miles, and I want to scout that little area in there. We're looking for mature deer this year. We just want to find some big deer, and between Pennsylvania and Maryland, I think we should be able to do that. And I actually just saw a deer already. But this video, I wanted to just kind of show you what I'm hunting, or what I will be hunting, and also give some tips to what I'm looking for when I'm scouting a new area. This is kind of different terrain than what we're used to in Pennsylvania. These are more rolling hills up in Tioga where Grant and I hunt. It's mountains. So this area, I'm kind of interested to see how the deer move in here, where they like to live and bed, and where their food is, travel points. The deer are going to do similar things compared to the deer up north, but I'm sure there's some differences. So I want to get in here today. I have about 2 to 3 hours, and I just want to learn as much as I can to give myself a good chance to kill some deer in here, whether it's a doe, mature buck, whatever it is. I'm also going to run 2 trail cameras in here, so I'll show you guys where I'm going to set them. I don't know yet, but I'm going to try and find some good sign, some good buck sign, and hopefully set up these cameras over it. Let's keep walking and we'll see what we can see today. So there's 3 elements to scouting, in my opinion, that are very key. The first one is to look at your topo maps. Understand the lay of the land before you go in there. The second one, get the boots on the ground. Spend as much time in the area you want to hunt as possible. You've got to learn what these deer are doing, where they're living, where their food source is. Third for scouting, running some trail cameras. Grant and I, we've talked over the years, it's going to be very rare that we shoot a deer on public land that we have on trail camera. It's not out of the question, it's going to be rare. But we want to know what's in the area. So we are going to run upwards of 20 to 25 cameras this year, all over different areas, just learning. Some of these cameras we'll check periodically whenever we hunt the area, but once it's deer season, we're not making any special trips into areas to check cameras. If we don't get to the camera this season, we'll let it soak until it's shed season, when we can get in there in February and March, and we'll just get a whole bunch of intel for that entire season. If we don't get much on that camera, we know it's a bust, and that's okay with us. We want to learn where the deer are, where they aren't. We can eliminate the spots that those deer aren't, and greater increase our chance of having success on mature deer. Going back to our first point of scouting, getting to know your topo map, we like to use Onyx. We use Onyx all the time. Grant and I are always sharing pins, sharing ideas, sharing locations that we think these deer can live. Onyx is a great tool. Whatever app you use, just find an app that has a topo map and you're golden. So right here behind me is a perfect example of something I look for. It's a bench. I'll swing the camera around so you guys can see it. It might be a little tough to see, but this is actually an old skitter trail that they would have brought logs out when they logged this area. But you can see the hillside goes up like this. It flattens out in here and drops off. These deer, or the bucks, will bed on this edge looking down over. So in the morning, the thermals will be rising so they can smell and see anything below them. And they'll bed here when the wind is coming over the top, so they can smell what's behind them, the things that they can't see. That's what they want to smell. And like Dan Infault says, wherever you find a balloon in the woods, big bucks are close. So what we have here is there's a little bluff right behind me here. It goes straight up, and then there's this point that comes out, and it's a little flatter. It's not that big of an area, but this could be an area where the deer are feeding. I'm seeing some remainders of scat and also some remnants of acorns. The sign is going to be a little difficult to see this time of year, especially when it's from last fall, but we should still be able to see somewhat of a scrape, some beds, and hopefully the food source. But this could look good. I'm not seeing any buck sign yet, but I'm not even to where I need to be yet. So I'm going to pin this on Onyx just kind of as a reference point. Future down the road, if I feel the need, I can come in here and set up and possibly whack a doe. But I like the looks of this. Good food around here, it seems. But looks like it's going to rain and storm here. I don't know how well you guys can see this. You see this deer trail? You see how the ferns are turned differently right there? And then you can see the leaves are discolored right out there along my finger. Deer trail right through there. This area is kind of interesting to me. So what we have is we have like a bowl in this area, and there's a ravine going right down the middle of it. Small ravine, not very big at all. But this ground, you probably can't tell, but it's distressed. I'm guessing that these deer were in here feeding over the winter time. Doesn't look like fresh scratching, but they were definitely here at some point. Just up the hill here, I heard a couple deer take off, so I know they're in the area. This hillside here comes to a point, and then right over here, it's another point with a little bench on, and I have that pinned from Onyx. And I'll show you a screenshot of what I'm talking about right now. You can see that there's a little flat, and you can see where the contour lines are just a little further apart, and that's where I'm headed to next, because I think that could be really good. It's so blazing hot today. Humid. Got to put in the work to kill the deer. So what I found here is that ravine that I was talking about earlier, that small ravine where the ground was a little bit distressed. I'm at the top of that now, and it kind of bowled out. And I think this tree right there, that tree is going to be a killing tree for me. I'm going to mark that because I'm standing on a deer trail, and I bet you there's going to be another trail up there. I'm going to do a recon and see if this trail and then this trail up here converge. And then I'm also going to drop down in to see if there's one below this tree within range. I really like this. Deer don't necessarily like changing elevation all that much. So what they do is they follow the contours, and they'll follow the top of this bowl right around. They don't necessarily like to go down in. And they'll go down in there if they're pushed, but on a normal travel route, they will work the edge so that they don't have to exert too much energy. So here's another trail right here. These trails are always tough to see on the camera, but not a heavy trail, but it definitely is getting used. And I'm still only about 10 yards from the base of my tree. So I already have two trails within 10 yards. And I just like the looks of this. It's kind of open. I think there's a little field up in here, which would be cool to, I mean, I could even find a tree up in there too. It looks like a little open spot. I don't know if it's a field or not, but I'm just gonna keep working this way and see if I can see any more trails, and I'll see if I can get up in there and see what's up there. Well, here's the first buck rub. I think it's definitely from last year. Not a very big buck. Tines are only about 36 inches off the ground, but still, it's the first buck rub I've seen, so it's pretty cool. I'll pin that and keep moving. I think we're getting into some buck sign here. Just found that one rub, and I got two more right here, and there's some good ones. I'm just not seeing a lot of trails, but this could be a rub line. That one I just found right back here, about 25 yards, so I'm guessing this could be a rub line. So I might try and find one little trail in here. These buck, they travel different routes than the doe do. They usually are between 10-30 yards away from the doe. So their trails aren't going to be as heavy because there's more doe than buck. The doe travel those trails and really hammer them down. But these buck, they travel just a little bit off that trail and their trails are faint. But if you can get on a good buck trail, you're bound to have some success or at least see some buck. So I'm going to pin these two rubs, try and find a little trail in here, and I'm going to actually put a trail camera in here. I think this is a really good spot. We're about a mile deep and I just don't think a lot of people are in here. There's a couple trails, like hiking trails, maybe a half to a quarter mile that way, but they're pretty far from the parking lot, so I'm not too worried about that. I'm here on this little flat again. I'm telling you, these flats, these military crests, are just killer for big deer. And this flat comes out, it drops off right on that edge. There are these buck rubs, and I bet you there's going to be some trails too, possibly some bedding. Here's the first one, just kind of scratched it up with his tines, and then the other one behind him a little bit better. Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah, and his tines are all the way up here. I'd say maybe 40 inches off the ground. That's a great sign right there. Guys, like I said, this military crest, these bucks could be bedded here. I just found a bed. It's old, so I can't really tell how big it is, but it's definitely a bed because there's hair in it. And that's a really good sign. I am not 10 feet from those two big buck rubs. Definitely where I'm gonna put my camera. And there's not a lot of trails in here, but these beds are here, the rubs are here, and the buck are here. So hopefully we can get some of these buck on camera. So right here's the bed. And if I zoom in close enough here, if I can find it again, right there. See that hair in there? That's a bed. I'm gonna put my trail camera right on this tree right here, and right out here is the buck rubs, two buck rubs, and right there is that bed. So I'm hoping by putting it on this tree, I can watch that bed, those rubs, and if there's any little trails out in there, get them as well. All right, we got the camera set, Wild Game Innovations, and I actually put it on video mode because I want to see what this buck's doing if it's bedding here, and I want to see him rub that tree. So I don't think there's going to be a ton of deer on this trail camera, but I think there's going to be buck on it. And when you run your cameras on trails like this, on buck trails, you're not going to get a ton of pictures, but you're going to get buck, like I said. So we're gonna let this guy soak for a couple of months and we'll check it probably first month of the Maryland season when I'm in here to hunt, and hopefully we can capitalize on a couple of deer that are in here. Just like I was talking a little bit ago, how the deer like that military crest, found another instance where it's just picture perfect. You can see here, I came up from down here, came up, and there's this little flat spot right here. Just, I mean, it's not even 5 yards long. And sure enough, there's a nice size bed right in there. And there's hair all through it. And there's a trail coming right in through. Then you have the bed. And the trail goes right out the other side. If you can learn what these little benches look like on Onyx or whatever topographic map you're using, they can be killer. You don't have to waste your time going out there and trying to find them. If you can pinpoint them on a map and you can just go right to them. Yeah, you're gonna have to hunt a little bit to find some other stuff that you can't see on a topographic map, but benches are just killer, and you'll find sign on them. This one I would have never seen on Onyx because it's 5 yards long, but just in the general area here, there's a bench right above me, and right here on this little military crest, buck bed. That's so cool. Now this bed is for sure a buck bed. This bed is about 40 to 48 inches long, right on that military crest again. And there's a scrape down here and a good trail, and there are acorns everywhere. This is killer. And it's a little bit thicker in here. There's some mountain laurel and some rhododendron. This is where my second camera's going, for sure. I just gotta find out where. I wanna get as many trails as I can, and the food source and everything I can get in one picture, I wanna try and get it. So there's some trails coming right in here to the bed. There's a trail up here, trail down there. There's a scrape down there yet. Big flat up top, drops down off, flat, and then it keeps dropping down. Picture perfect every time, keep saying it. Be sure you're checking that top bench right off the top. So here's this bed. I'm gonna put my backpack in it just to show you the reference. The bed starts there and it stops over there. There's hair in it, there's acorns. He's got this bluff behind him. He's got this view right down in it, right down over. It's perfect, picture perfect. So guys, as you can see, there's a scrape right there. This is all just tore up, full of acorn shells. There's a trail coming right down through here. There's another trail going right up there. And my backpack, where that buck bed is right there. So what did I decide I'm gonna do? Trail camera on here. That scrape is right there. There's two trails that meet right here where I'm standing. There's a scrape there, scrape up here, and there's a trail right here. I'm gonna put my trail camera right on this tree, and we're gonna watch that area. That buck bed is just 20 yards up the hill here, right below that scrape. So trail camera is going to go on this tree, and I'm going to face it that direction, looking over that scrape, and hopefully get some deer on that trail camera, and hopefully some mature buck. Got the second wild game running here. Scrape, two trails, and a lot of acorns. Well, everybody, that's gonna be the end of this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the tips and the tactics that I've kind of shared with you guys today. Trail camera location, where the buck's bed, different things like that. Let me know in the comments, where have you had success? What contours, what land features? I wanna know where you guys have had success. It's always interesting hearing what other people have to say. You can learn from everybody that hunts. People just learn from being in the woods. I've been in the woods for like 10, 12 years now. There's guys that have been in longer than I have, and we'd like to know how you guys have had success and where you've had success. Get out there in the woods, get your feet on the ground, start doing some scouting. If you have trail cameras, get them out. These bucks are starting to really grow. Deer season is right around the corner, and we can't wait.